We cannot focus on the consumers' reports because they were very poor. Therefore, we are not concerned about consumer or patients' report. They have to tell the healthcare providers and healthcare provider to report for us. Our source of information, health professionals, literature, observational studies, and I will mention in one of my slides in details about the details about what we are doing, what is our planning in the future for observational studies, development and marketing partners, health authorities, and studies from phase one to phase four. Why? Because in Jordan we have CROs. And we conduct too much study by equivalence and phase three and phase four studies. And we have a special law for these studies. And they are a very rich source for safety information for pharmacologists. This is our guidelines in Arabic that have been translated, okay? As Dr. Amr said in Egypt, and also we are in Jordan, we have every company, they have to nominate one contact person or one local safety officer in every company. He must be a doctor or pharmacist. The company nominates him for us in a formal letter in order to follow every safety information with us, especially to safety issues, updated safety issues, or any critical quality issues in the products. Also, this doctor or pharmacist, we have some, we got for this contact person some characteristics. He has to be experienced, he has to have experience in pharmacovigilance, he has to have a degree of in medicine or pharmacy, he has to the ability to communicate, the ability to write SOPs, the ability to have information in pharmacology or biostatistics. Some communication issues. We have a health hazard evaluation committee. This committee in Jordan constituted from doctors, from academics, and specialists, and from GFDA. All of us, we expose the issue of safety for the committee and discuss it, and we make the recommendation to the concerned department. For example, for registration to withdraw or to recall, to make some recall of the product, or to make label update, or for the inspection to take some samples from the market. This is the one of the major missions of our committee. And also, in our website, we usually publish some summary about the issue that we can submit it on the website. Some quality issues, of course, we will not put it on the website because maybe it will make some conflict for the consumers. It depends on the case. We have Article 17. It's a very important article because, you know, in pharmacovigilance in Jordan, we will not only assess the reports that we have received. Also, we have a very important part, we play a very important part in related to the CTD, Common Technical File, Module 1 and Module 5. Therefore, we have to put some article about the periodicity of how to submit the BSURs and RMBs. This article for BSUR. In Jordan, we also, according to our capacity, we ask for BSUR submission for both originators and generics when you submit the file upon registration and upon re-registration. Okay, and when if there is any case, when we make a risk-benefit balance for the products, if there is any case required BSUR submission, they have to submit for us a bridge. Bridging BSURs, it depends on the case also. Article 18 about the risk management plan, and this is the more now active document that usually health authority like, or they prefer to, from the companies to submit that risk management plan. And as Dr. Am said, that in Arabic we focus on risk management plan submission, especially for the region. For Jordan, we ask the company to submit risk management plan to be applied locally in Jordan. What you are going to do in Jordan? Please explain for me in details what you are going to step by step to do in this drug for the patients. And you have to submit it for us periodically every 6 months and full of the safety information for you, the company evaluation also. Article 18, risk management plan, they have, because in Jordan we have originators, generics, local generics, and we have imported generics. So the situation, for some extent, it is complicated. We ask for both generic originators, all generics and originators, to submit upon registration the risk in RMB. And upon re-registration, the PSUR for both. This is why we want to differentiate between REMS in upon registration and REMS upon re-registration. The case in Jordan, we ask for all the products to submit for us REMS, but it depends case by case. If for example, if the company said that this product, and it clarified that this product is an old product, a grandfather product, safety profile is well known, there is no need to submit, they can deliver and submit the file without REMS. If not the case, they have to submit the risk management plan. This is a table comparison between the periodicity for submission of RMP and PSUR between generics and originators product. Also, we have the they have to submit the companies, of course, the expedited reporting. This is if we go to the reports between international regulations 715s. Also, we follow 715 days rule. For both generic and originators, we have a risk management plan and PSUR. They must be submitted when required by GFDA. And we have many examples in this. Okay, this is safety information in module 1. In pharmacovigilance in Jordan, because we work under the umbrella of registration department for 12 years. So till this moment, we are attached to the daily work of drug file. This was advantage for us, you know, because we know now the drug file in details from the visit. But at this time, lately, during the past 2 months, we work on pharmacovigilance only. In module 1, we ask for the companies now, when they want to submit the file, to describe for us detailed description DDBS, which is the pharmacovigilance system master file now replaced by this. And they have to make it like this, a checklist, some important information. We have to check this information that the company submit this information. For example, they have to nominate for us a QBB if it is on a multinational company. And they have, or local, sorry, local company, if they have regional office in Jordan, or agent, drug agent, he has to nominate for us contact person, local safety officer. They have to show us the number of the SODs that they are concerned in safety reporting, also for the quality issues, SODs for safety issues. How do they deal with the expedited reporting, their system, we make sure that every system, every agent, every company, they have their pharmacovigilance system. Okay? Also, archiving, documentation, if they have, do they have a software system, training, what kind of a training, qualifications. Now, we will not accept anyone to submit for us any paper concern safety issues if he doesn't know about pharmacovigilance, if he is not trained. Minimum training he has to take. Okay, BD promotional material, reporting forms, feedback mechanism, and published bulletin if available, if they have. Also, in Jordan, after merging with the Russian reviews, we have published our first newsletter bulletin. ان شاء الله I will send it for your emails after some modifications in our software. Okay, feedback mechanism, okay, guidelines, references, what kind of guidelines? Also, we ask the companies for very important things, which is a safety agreement. And I'm going down to safety agreement just because it will cover all this. Why? Because safety agreement usually determines the relation between the agent and the company, or the agent, the company, and the company, and the responsibility for each part. This is why I need to have to see the exact safety agreement between the two parts. By this, I can determine your responsibility is to remind or to submit for me the expedited reporting, the periodic reporting, to inform me about any quality issues, urgent safety restrictions, what you are going to do. And this is why we have to read the safety agreement. They have to show us their auditing, quality management activities, what kind of activities they do, and they must be ready for inspection because within 1 year we are going to do inspection on all companies in Jordan and agents. And now we start with one company and one agent as an example to make inspection on their pharmacovigilance system. Okay. If we come to safety information module 5, this is related to CTD, common technical file. Module 5, usually when registration department now they send for us PSURs and risk management plan, we evaluate these reports, two reports, PSURs and RMBs, and we send for them our assessment, our own assessment recommendation. And they will add it in their formal letter with the deficiencies for the other parts in the common technical files. As you know, this is the module requirement for new marketing applications and hybrid generics, similar biologicals. We follow this checklist in evaluating the RMBs. Also, it is approved from Arab League guidelines. This is our own checklist. You know, usually in Jordan, and to summarize the situation for you, our team is very small in number. Now we are 5, okay? And this is why we have to minimize the requirement, to make it lose its efficiency, but for example, pre-clinical studies, we will not evaluate it. It's not our business. We work on phase 4 only, for clinical, for everything related to post-marketing. Therefore, we make a checklist, and this is approved in Jordan, for the safety information. This is the same list, a checklist, for the evaluation of RMB. And we have here the comparison for approving the PSURs between originators and generics. You know, we take everything the same between generics and originators, unless generics they waiver the document. Presentation of case individual histories, sometimes we will not ask them from generics. Normally, we ask on two main documents in the file. First, SNPC and the insert leaflet. Some cases, we ask for the core data case. If we find that the product, we have some safety information available, or there is a conflict in the information between the reference safety information or SNPC and the company core, we ask for the company core data share. But the main safety information, we ask the company to submit that the SNPC are in the insert leaflet. Okay, this is the comparison between the generics and the requirements for the file. expedited reporting. Also, we use, we follow the international regulations. So we usually focus on the 7-15 days reporting from the companies to GFD to receive a complete report, complete information report. Yesterday, I heard one question from one colleague about DDL. We had experience, good experience in DDL in Jordan. We find that some companies, they submit for us results from phase 4 studies, clinical studies, and heavy, okay? And they consider for us in heavy work and not to do. When we evaluate this in our committee, health and information committee, we found that DDL, Dr. Gatar, should be submitted only in special cases. What kind of cases? We have to receive the serious and expected safety information. This is a new safety information. Should be safety, new safety information, not labeled in the label. And by this, we can disseminate this information. We approve the call for the company, give approval for the company to disseminate this information between healthcare providers. Why? Because yani, too much DDL, the doctors will not concern about the information. This is from our experience, and it was successful because we make limitation for the kind of safety information to be disseminated, and we have the time also to approve this kind of letters. Okay. How do we use the data? In Jordan, you know, maybe the situation because we have a small population, I mean, all Jordanian people with our guest, maybe one never went in Cairo. Number of reports in Jordan are not too much. But this year we have received 200 reports. We have 175 reports. They were good quality, 25 now. This is why we are now trying to evaluate these reports and to make a study analysis, inshallah. At the end of June, we have end up with a study concerning our reports in 2013 and 2014. How do we use this data? Identify potential hazard of the drug, evaluating the reactions we have not seen in clinical studies, update our SNBC insert leaflets, reflect PSURs. I will focus on this. I don't know in the Gulf or Kuwait you have this issue like us in Jordan. Now most of the companies, they change the label, their label into BIL, okay? In Jordan, for example, we don't have this NBC to be disseminated between the doctors, healthcare providers. Just only the BIL. The BIL, it is very summarized, no safety information. Sometimes they don't write the dose, the detailed dose in the leaflet. It will constitute a problem for us. And what to do? Now, it is one of the challenges to make or ask the companies to disseminate the SNBC as a document for the doctors, because the BIL is not sufficient. It is only for the patients to know some information about their medications. Okay? Also, inform healthcare providers and patients about potential risk. Dear Dr. Gatar, medication guide. Usually we use too much, we ask too much about medication guide, especially for non-retributive index drugs. And ensure it ensure the ongoing safety review throughout its life. This is our main task in pharmacovigilance in Jordan. Inshallah, after maybe 3 months, we will evaluate the situation between national and regional reviews. And we have projects now with the multinational companies and local companies. We have 6 projects, and we are going to make phase 4 studies, observational studies, head-to-head study, comparing between genetics and originators, because we have too much genetics and we have too much originators. We have competition and we have tenders time. Sometimes we receive during tenders time a cluster of reports. This it will be sometimes not ethical. And therefore, we ask, and we put one article, we will not accept any report during tenders time, because it will be critical. If you want, we will see the flow of kinds of, reports during daily. Okay. What are the regulatory actions like other, countries, Saudi Arabia, Egypt, our neighbors? You know, we all do the same. Our regulatory action dealt with data delegation by secular healthcare providers. Now in Jordan, we are using the technology, alhamdulillah, we send SMS for every critical safety information. For all healthcare providers, we have contact with the doctors' associations, and we send the SMS for them, and they will send disseminate this through mobile SMS. So it was a great experience for us and the group and the chief. Okay, update national leaflet. We ask for all local companies to update and safety information. We accept the updating of safety information for generics if they submitted before the originators, only for safety issues. Special cases quality, to be honest with you, 50% of our work in pharmacovigilance is quality issues. And they voluntarily submitted from companies. And I wonder sometimes we make some regulatory actions. I don't know if other health authorities will receive this, but we make too much regulatory actions according to or referring to quality issues. For such as for contamination, low efficacy of the product, recalls, building exportation or importation, or both together, and with the provider of the product. This is all also our regulatory action taken by GMDA. This is a summary of our accomplishment during 2013. DDA dissemination more than 100 letter, label update, because we talked DDA dissemination more than 100 letter, but we, after the health hazard evaluation committee, this decision to only focus on serious and expected information. Label update more than 260, recalls 16 recall for the product recall of batches with the double 3 recommendations. RMBs reviewing 13 RMBs during 2013, and we did now after emerging, we did 17 reviewing of RMB, PSUR's assessment 48 reports, and now after emerging we did 35 reports. This is a summary, and usually in my presentation I like to put the summary in how we work in Jordan. The small team work like this. We receive the reports, okay, from healthcare provider, or from principal investigator in clinical studies, and we do a causality assessment. Here, usually we do causality assessment for serious reports, only serious cases, and if it is not serious, it will go directly to the PSUR, and if it is serious side effects, we have to also go after assessment, it will go to company core data sheet and PSURs, and if it is serious unexpected, now, like all the world, if it is fatal life-threatening, 7-15 days rule, it will be applied, it will be, and we consider it as results, and then it will go to, if we need to do some risk management in that, we will do, if they need to make it to put it to PSUR, to add it to PSUR, it depends according to the periodicity of report period. If it is serious, other serious, after all assessment, they will add the company to company called data sheet. And there is too much negotiation between us and the companies. How do they put, why do they put this information in the company core and reference, and then why they do add it to the reference safety information? Sometimes they put critical safety information and reference safety information, they don't add it to the summary of product characteristics. This sometimes will be critical for us. And we have to know why this critical information till this moment not added to the SMBC. And sometimes, most of the time, they reply for us. Our challenges in Jordan, more awareness among healthcare providers. Since the establishment of Jordan Pharmacovigilance in 2001, till this moment, we did a lot of workshops and lectures. And and we noticed that during the year, we make too much presentations, lectures, we have more reports. If we stop or decrease our promotion, we find that the reports will, number of reports will decrease. Student awareness in Faculty of Medicine and Pharmacy. We have one project now, it's a very nice project with the Faculty of Pharmacy at Jordan University. We students for in the fourth year and fifth, we give them summary, of course, in pharmacovigilance, and it was successful this year. Database improvement, we have to improve our software and kind of database, self-decision to our programs, and increase our staff number. Future plan, several activities in the field of collaboration with multinational and local companies. Activities organized by hospitals, like now we have one branch in Al-Karak, in the south of Jordan, in Al-Karak Hospital, Al-Karak University, and now we are going to make in two new branch in Jordan University and in the Mustashfa Hospital, Malik Abdullah Hospital. And by this, at the end of June, we will have three branches in addition to our main office. Satisfied participation in global activities recognized in the region. In addition to our colleagues in Egypt and Syria and Kuwait, inshallah. Okay, this is a number of reports in, for adverse drug reactions. As we see, but in 2013 we have received 600 from KHCC, Kim Hussein, for cancer, but we didn't add it because till this moment we are analyzing this data. This is the chart for the quality issues in Jordan. You know it, how many cases we received per year. Okay, and this is a summary. Where we are concerned in monitoring the labeling in the drug for the drug, especially we are taking care for watching warning and the precaution section, adverse reactions, overdose, and those administration should not be sometimes changed, and if they change, if they have, we have to transfer the leaflet to the committee who registered the drug, especially for application, dosage, and administration. And wait a minute. This is an example for us, incidents of adverse drug reactions in the Al-Karak Hospital. It was a pilot study done by our colleague, is a member of Health Hazard Evaluation Committee. We have 1,600 patients, 8% suffered from one more than ADR. 50% of ADRs were avoidable. One patient died during admission and his death was contributed to an ADR. It was anaphylaxis. This is the case in Jordan. Thank you.